Good afternoon students, welcome back to the class. Dear students, in our previous class we discussed about the number system and also the types of number system. As we discussed in the previous class, the number system is a way to represent the numbers and which can be divided into two types. One is non-positional number system, another one is positional number system. In the non-positional number system, we are using some symbols to represent the numbers. So the best example of the non-positional number system is the Roman numbers. And the second one is positional number system. In this positional number system, which can be divided into four types, that is decimal number system, binary number system, octal and hexadecimal number system. So about these all we discussed in the previous class. So in this class we shall move on to the next concept, that is number system conversions. These number systems are going to converting into the different number system. That are, in this class we discussed the three different number system conversions of three different number system. One is decimal to binary, and the second one is decimal to octal, and the third one is decimal to hexadecimal. So here in the first one, decimal to binary conversion, so already we discussed about the types of this number system. In this decimal, which is has a 10 numbers, that is 0 from 0 to 9, and so the radix of or base of this decimal number system is 10. And in the binary number system, it is has a two values, that is ones and zeros. So here the radix or base is 2, and in the case of octal decimal, it has a 8 numbers from 0 to 7. Hence it is base is 8. And in the case of hexadecimal, which is has 16 numbers from 0 to 15. So it's the base is 16. So here we are adding all the positional values in the power of 10 to 8 and hexadecimal in the corresponding number system. So here in the first conversions, the first conversions of this number system is decimal to binary. The first conversion is decimal to binary. When we are going to convert the decimal number into binary number system, we have to follow some procedure. That is, the first one is, first of all, they are given one decimal numbers like a 2, 3, 5. These are all the example of decimal number system. So when we are converting from decimal to binary number system, we are going to follow some instructions or a step. In that, the first one is dividing given decimal numbers by the 2, because first we are going to converting from decimal to binary, and then now decimal number na binary number aagi convert maartirudinda kottiruvanta decimal numbers na naavu eradinda divide maadbeku. So the given decimal numbers are divided by the 2s. The second procedure is write all quotient and remainder. Write all the quotient and remainder until quotient become zero. Andre quotient become zero. The second step is write all the quotient and reminders until the quotients become zero. Andre now divide maartta hodaga ella quotients matte reminders na note maartkonta hogtivi illi tanka andre until the quotients become zero. In the decimal to binary conversions, the first reminder, which is called as here the first reminder, which is called as least significant bit, that is called LSB, least significant bit, that is LSB, and the last reminder, it called as most significant bit, that is called MSB. So here the first step is dividing all the given numbers by the 2s, because here we are converting from decimal to binary. The second step is write all the quotients and reminder until the quotients become 0, and then here the first reminder is called as least significant bit and the last reminder is called as most significant bits. The third step is write all the equivalents, of binary numbers. Now divide ಮಾಡಿದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಯಾವ ಬೈನರಿ ನಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೋ ಆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬೈನರಿ ನಂಬರ್ಸ್ ನಾವು ರೈಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕು. ಎಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್, ಆರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ MSB to LSB. So this decimal to binary conversions is required some steps, that is dividing the given decimal numbers by 2 and write all the quotients and reminders until the quotients become 0, and here the first reminder is called as least significant and last reminder is called as most significant. And after writing all the quotients and reminders, write all the equivalence binary numbers from the left to right. Let me consider one example, then you will understand. The example of this decimal to binary conversions is 2, 3, 4. Here this is the given decimal number. Then if he wants to get the binary conversions to this case, so it can be represented in binary number as, which can be represented when, let me go through a step. The first step is divide the given decimal number by, so this is a given decimal number, dividing by 2, because here we are going to convert it from decimal to binary. So here 2 ones are 2, remaining 1, and 2 twos are, here remaining 1 is, it's a 14, so 2 sevens are 14, here we get a 0 remainder. Again going to divide it, this value, this quotient by the 2, then 2 fives are 10, remaining 1, 2 8s are 16, remaining 1. So again divided by the 2, then 2 2s are 4, there is no remainder. So 2 4s are 8, here 0. And again divided into 2, 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, again 0. Again divided by 2, 2 6s are 12, so 0. And 2 3s are 6, 0, again 2. 2 1s are 2, remaining 1. So here the last quotient is 0. Here we can't get a 0 quotients. So after dividing the given decimal numbers by the 2, then the third step is write all the equivalence binary numbers from left to right. Then the given decimal number is 2, 3, 4. This is the decimal numbers. Then after converting this decimal into binary, we get the answer, that is 1 1 0 0 0 0 0 and 1 and 0. So this is the binary equivalence. So this is the procedures to follow to converting from decimal to binary. ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರುವಂತಹ ಡೆಸಿಮಲ್ ನಂಬರ್ಸ್ ನ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಟೂ ಇಂದ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋದ್ರೆ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ರಿಮೈಂಡರ್ಸ್ ನ ಅಂಟಿಲ್ ಜೀರೋ ಬರೋ ತನಕ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತೆ reminders na en maadbeku from left to right illanu barkotivi. This is called as conversions of decimals from decimal to binary equivalence. Then we got the result is 1100010. This is called binary numbers. So this is about the first conversions, that is decimal to binary. Next we'll move on to the second conversions, that is decimal to octal. When we converting from decimal to octal, it is also followed some same procedure, that is, but the changes is when we are going to converting from decimal to octal, we have to divide in the given decimal numbers by the 8. By 8, and write all the questions and reminder until the questions become 0. And here also the first reminder is also called as least significant bit, and most last reminder is also called as most significant bit. And the third procedure is write all the equivalence octal numbers. All the equivalence octal numbers from left to right. So let me consider one example, then you will get understand. The example of this conversions of octal to binary. Sorry, decimal to octal. The second one is conversions of decimal to octal. Decimal to octal. So we are dividing the given decimal number by 8. Let me consider one example, that is 4, 5, 9. This is the decimal number. The conversion of octal is, solve here. The given decimal number is 4, 5, 9. This is decimal. We have to convert it into octal numbers. So here dividing given decimal numbers by 8. First procedure is dividing the given decimal numbers by 8. So here 18 into 5 is 40. So 8 5 is 40. Remaining is 5. Here 8 7 is 56, because here we got a 59 value. So 8 7 is 56. So remaining thing is 3. 59 here we have a 59. So 8 7 is 56. The remainder is 3. Again divided by the 8 8 7 is 56. Then we got only one remainder. So here this 7, it's can't divided by the 8 because this question is smaller than 8. So this is the final answer that we got. 7 1 3, this is octal. So here the decimal numbers 4 5 9, we got a octal conversion is 7 1 3. So when we have to converting from decimal to octal, we have to divide in the given decimal numbers by 8. Write all the questions and reminders until the questions become 0. And now after, write all the equivalence octal numbers from left to right. Here, this first reminder is called as least significant bit, and the last reminder is called as most significant bit. So after dividing, we have to note down all the equivalence the octal numbers from left to right or from MSB to LSB. So this is about the second conversions, that is decimal to octal. So now we move on to the third conversions, that is decimal to hexadecimal. The third conversion is decimal to hexadecimal. The third one is decimal to hexadecimal. Here this hexadecimal is having a 16 numbers from 0 to 15, and so the radix of this hexadecimal is 16. So when we have to convert it from decimal to hexadecimal, we have to divide in the given decimal numbers by 16, because the base or a radix values of this hexadecimal is 16. So the second step is, here also same procedure is followed. Write all the questions and reminder until the questions become 0. And here also the first reminder is called as least significant bit, and the last reminder, which is called as most significant bit. After dividing given decimal numbers by the 8, write all the equivalents of hexadecimal number. Equivalents of all hexadecimal numbers from left to right, then we got the conversions value of this hexadecimal. Let me consider one example. The example is hexadecimal example is 559. This is a given decimal numbers. To this decimal numbers, we have to convert in the hexadecimal value. We are solving here. The hexadecimal value is 559, which can be divided by the 16, because it is the conversions of decimal to hexadecimal. Here 16 into 3 we got a 48, 16 into 4 we got a 64 value. Here the 64 is more than this 55, so we are going to divide it by 16 into 3. When 16 threes are 48, the remaining is 70, because 55 minus 48 we got a 7 value. So we got a 7 value. Again 16 into 4, that is 64, and 16 into 5, again we got a 80. This is more than this 79. Hence we are go to the 16 into 4, that is 16 fours are 64, the remaining is 50. 16 into 4 is 40, 64, so remaining is 50. 79 minus 64, then we get a 50 value, so the remainder is 15. Remainder is 15. Again divided these questions by 16, then we get 16 into 2, that is 32. So 16 twos are 32, we get. Got the remainder is only 2. Again we can't divide this question 2 by the 16, because this question's 2 value is smaller than this 16. So this is the final answer. We got this 2 2, and again the 15 value is F. This is 16, because in the hexadecimal the digits A, B, C, D, E, F, these digits which is having the decimal equivalents 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. So here the value of 15 is F. So we got the result is 2 to F. So finally we got the output from this 559 decimal to hexadecimal conversion is 2 to F. So this is the conversions from decimal to hexadecimal. When we have to convert it from decimal to binary octal and hexadecimal, first step is we are following these procedures for all the three conversions. First we have to divide the given decimal numbers by the given binary octal or hexadecimal. Again write all the conditions and reminders until the questions become 0. After dividing, write all the equivalence values of this binary numbers, octal numbers or hexadecimal numbers from left to right. We can write in these directions, left to right. This is right, this is left. This first remainder is called as LSP and the last remainder is called as MSP. So we have to write in all the equivalence of given binary octal and hexadecimals from MSP to LSP. Then we got the conversions value of this given decimal numbers. So as we converting from decimal to decimal to binary octal or hexadecimal, again we have to convert, we have some procedure to converting from binary octal hexadecimal to the given decimal number system. We will see in one conversions in this class. First we converting from decimal to binary octal and hexadecimal. Again we have a possibility to converting from binary to decimal, octal to decimal and hexadecimal to decimal. These three conversions are also following some procedure. So we discuss the first conversion, that is binary to decimal. Binary to decimal conversions. Here we are going to follow the procedure as the first one is multiplying two by the given weight. I will tell you the clarification. Multiplying the each bit of binary numbers or hexadecimal numbers or octal numbers by its positional. Multiplying the each binary values. From its positional weight. Andre kottiruvanta binary numbers na adalle adanna positional weight inda multiply maartta hodre they will get the decimal conversions. Let me consider in second procedure is adding all the products. Multiply aadmele namge en products sigutho adellanu finally add binary. So the first step is multiplying each binary values or each octal values or each hexadecimal values from its positional weight. So here the first conversion is binary to decimal. So the binary value, positional value of the binary weight is 2. So the positional value of decimal is 10, positional value of octal and hexadecimal is 8 and 16 respectively. So here we are converting from binary to decimal. So here we consider the positional value of this binary is 2. So let me take one example, that is 11011 into 11. This is the given binary values. We have to convert this binary value into decimal value. So here the first procedure is multiply each binary values from its positional weight is here 1 into the positional weight of the binary number is 2. So plus 1 into 2 plus 0 into 2 plus 1 into 2 plus 1 into 2 plus 1 into 2 plus 1 into 2. So multiplying each binary values from its positional weight, then adding the positional values from the 0 before the fractional points. So here that's 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Here after the point we adding the positional values from minus 1, minus 2 respectively. So here 1 into 2 to the power of 4 means 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. Then 2 2 are 4, 4 2 are 8, 8 2 are 16. So here 1 into 16 plus 1 into 8 plus 0 into 4 plus 1 into 2 plus 1 into 1. Because any numbers which is having the positional value 0, then that value is 1. Any value which is having the positional value 0, then the value is 1. So 2 to the power of 0 positional value is 1 plus 1 into 2 to the power of minus 1. As I told in the past class, when we have to get a minus 1 positional value, we are going to divide in that 1 divided by binary given numbers. And if you want to get a positional numbers minus 2, then we have to divide in 2 square. When it is comes to the denominator, it will be a square. So here 1 into 2 to the power of minus 1 means 1 divided by 2, that is 0.5 value. And 1 divided by 2 to the power of 2 square means 1 divided by 4. The value of 1 divided by 4 is 0.25. So here 1 into 0.5 plus 1 into 0.25. Then simplify this. 16 into 1 16 plus 8 into 1 8 plus 0 into anything is 0, so it is 0, plus 1 into 2 is 2 plus 1 into 1 is 1. Here 1 into 0.5 is plus 0.5 plus 1 into 0.25 is 0.25. then adding, second step is adding all these products, then we get 16 plus 8 is 24, 24 plus 2 is 26, 26 plus 1 is 27. Here we have a fractional values, that is point value, then we get a 0, 6 to 5. So we got that the final answer is 26.625. This is the decimal numbers. So this is the procedures we have to follow to converting from binary to decimal. The first step is multiplying each binary values from this positional bit, that is here binary to decimal. So here we are multiplying these two values, positional values of these binaries too. So multiplying these two with this binary numbers, finally we got this decimal conversion. So this is about the conversions of binary to decimal. So okay, I will stop here. In the next class, we will continue with the conversions of octal to decimal, hexadecimal to decimal, and also another conversions. Okay, thank you all.